Now, after her terrible Jacinda Ardern cake made world headlines, Laura Daniel has been trying to redeem herself by making a better effort of turning all of our political party leaders into cakes.
Tonight, her political baking journey concludes right where it started, with Labor leader Jacinda Ardern.
When I turned the Prime Minister into a cake on 7 Sharp, it sent shockwaves through the world's media. When I turned all the other leaders into cakes, I got slightly better at it.
Holy f***.
Tonight, a do-over. I finally go face-to-face with Jacinda Ardern. To honour my original monstrosity, I went with the same ingredients, classic kiwi lolly cake and inedible prosthetic teeth. The results? I mean, the bar was pretty low.
Was the original cake I made for you the hardest thing you had to deal with as Prime Minister in 2020?
No, but it was as horrifying as 2020.
Are you ready to see the cake?
Let's do the ominous reveal.
There we go.
Oh! Wow, that is a vast improvement. I feel like you have really downplayed my smile a little bit in this one relative to the last one in which I think it was really pronounced.
All right, well, you're ready to cut into yourself, Jacinda.
It's a little odd.
You do actually have to cut into this cake. Before you're allowed anything.
You want me to cut into the COVID scan?
You've got a chicken,
I've
really.
Got a chicken on the QR code.
Yeah.
No, it does not recognise.
Do you know how hard it is to pick up the normal code sometimes?
I've actually found it not too bad.
Yeah, the app has gotten better, but yeah. I mean, it's obviously buggy if it's not picking that up because that's a work of art, so.
And what have you gone with?
I've gone with lolly cake.
I'm glad you've said that because otherwise I would have thought quite dense.
It has been in the fridge overnight. And there's another piece. Yeah, perfect. Okay.
Just a little. May I?
Yes, you may.
Beautifully done. That is a lot of lolly and not a lot of cake.
Jacinda, I've got one vote this election, one party vote. Do you want it?
Yes.
Why?
I personally believe, obviously, that we have the best plan for New Zealand coming through COVID. And I will take it as a really strong personal endorsement if I get your vote, like I voted for you in Dancing for the Stars.
Now let's talk referendums. The flag referendum. When are we going to have another one?
I really feel like that $26 million on the first round was sufficient.
You don't want to chuck another $26
million? I really feel like New Zealanders express their indifference and I think it's time to park that one.
You've been pretty vocal with your support towards the end of life choice.
Yeah, I've been asked for my opinion on that because that one actually was always, you know, first of all went to Parliament before it ended up as a referendum. So my vote was public there, I voted in favour of it.
What about the cannabis referendum?
Yeah.
Now, you've been a little bit quiet on your view on that. Wouldn't it be amazing if you finally took a stance in the light-hearted 7 Sharp cake segment?
I am now suddenly sitting here thinking, what's really in the lolly cake? That's now where I'm at.
Why does everyone think I put weed in the cake? If it becomes legal, I'd bring you some down before we had the cake.
Well, I think obviously we're going to have to wait for a referendum on that. And what I've been saying is that actually no matter the outcome, I want you to have faith that I'll implement it. And I will, whether people vote for it or against it.
Now, there is a bit of Jacinda mania going around. Do you have any of your own merch?
In Christchurch, someone gave me a car freshener with my face on it.
Do you have it in your car?
I gave one to Clark for the ute.
I've been gifted a lot of Jacinda merch.
Have you?
Yeah.
Just because of...
I got given like a skirt with 100 little Jacinda faces on it. And did you know that existed?
I thought it was just a Photoshop joke.
Oh, well, it's very wearable. I've got it on now if you want to see. You know.
Oh, that's fetching.
It's actually good. It's good underwear. It's like
Spanx.
You can wear it as a dress, you can wear it, you know, but I just like to have it on most of the time.
It's lime green. And that was a lot of my face.
Okay, so how do you reckon this cake compares to the one you made beneath?
This one is, I'd have to say, more stable. True test is whether you could stand it upright.
You
obviously.
Can. Look, there you go. And now you can put this on your wall.
Well, I reckon that would last, actually.
Yeah.
I think
we could put it here, or I could take it to Papa.
Or, you know what, side of the Whitcalls building at Christmas. Because there's something really similar going on there.